Okay, don't write anything, only listen. I'll give you time to make the notes later, okay? Okay, so ER and IR is like clear now. So moving forward to the third category, that is RE ending verbs. So how do we identify that the verb is RE ending? If it is, for example, let's see the verb ATONDRA. It is ending with RE. So basically we check the last two letters like we do for ER and IR ending verbs. For ER, IR, we also do the same thing. That if there is a verb which is ending with ER, it falls in the ER category. If there is a verb which is ending with RE, it falls in the RE category verb. So for RE, there are a lot of irregular verbs. Okay, the regular verbs are... Just a second, Kushal. So we have a lot of irregular verbs here, but first we are going to start with the basic regular verbs. So whenever we are conjugating the RE ending verb, first thing we do is that we remove the ending. Okay, that is, we remove RE. After removing RE, what we get is known as the radical of the verb. Radical or the stem. Okay, in that stem, we add S, D. Okay, because it's actually ending with D, so we don't add anything. So you have to remember that it should be, you know, it should be ending with D. Then your ONS, EZ, and ENT. Okay, so for example, I have to conjugate the verb ATONDRA. Okay, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to remove RE, correct? So what will left? ATTEND.
END, S. S.
S we will add. Okay, so now when I conjugate, it will be ATTEND. S, with you also, it's going to be the same word. ATTEND, S. With LL, we will not add anything. It's going to be same. ATTEND and ATT. Now, when you are conjugating with nu, vu, ilel, you are simply going to add the endings nu, aton, do, the er endings, d, o, n, s. With vu, it's going to be z.
ENT, ENT.
Okay, so this is the conjugation that we get. Just. It's very simple. You just have to remove the ending RE, and you have to remember with JATHU, you are going to add SS. With IL and L, you do not add anything. With your NU, VU, ILL, you simply add the ending. That are the endings of your regular RE ending, ER ending verbs. Now, moving forward, this is the ATONDRA conjugation we have done. We have a list of verbs which are conjugated like ATONDRA. ATONDRA basically means to wait. So if I say JATON, it means I am waiting. Okay, what are the other list of verbs conjugated like ATONDRA? We have VONDRA, which means to sell something. We have RONDRA, which means to return something. We have DISONDRA, which means to go down, to come down. Then we have repondra, that is to respond, and we have antondra, which means to hear. So these are the general ER, very popular RE ending verbs which are also conjugated like atondra. Okay, any doubt? No? Okay, just do one thing. I'll just scroll up, write the regular one, then we'll move forward to the irregular. Just write these first. Note these down. So these are the basically regular RE ending verbs we have. Now moving forward to the irregular one, the first category we have is the three verbs that we have. Prendre, which means to take. Comprendre, to understand. And apprendre, to learn. These three basically, if you see, they are rhyming as well. Prendre, comprendre, apprendre. Okay, to learn. So like, what happens when you are conjugating the verbs apprendre, comprendre, and prendre? So what happens when you are conjugating prendre, apprendre, and comprendre? For the pronouns, je, tu, il, and elle, you remove re as in the endings. Okay, so for example, the prendre is the verb, so what will you get? Prend. But for nous, vous, il, and elle, you are going to remove dre. So what will you get? Pren. The endings are going to be same. Je prends, prends. Tu prends, prends. We don't add anything with il and elle, so it's going to be same. Prend. With nous, now you are going to remove d as well. So what will be the radical? Preon. So in this, you are going to add ons. With vous, pren. Ez, and with your ill and l, that is the plural one. What happens here? You double the n and then add ent. So this is the conjugation which you have to remember. There are different things which are changing. For prendre, comprendre, and apprendre, first you are going to remove only re for the first four pronouns, then you are going to remove dre for the remaining four, and also double the n before adding the endings. This happens for all the three pronouns, comprendre, apprendre, and prendre. Any doubt here? Or understood?
Ma'am, for the pronouns, you wrote prend and pren. That is the radical, right?
Yeah, prend and pren, it's the radical that is left, yeah.
Can you repeat?
Found the whole conjugation?
No, ma'am, that last one, ent.
Afan, what happens with ent and ells is that when you remove the ending dre, you get pren. Okay, you will get pren. So according to the rule, it simply says ki aap ons and ez ko add kar do, right? But actually, jab aap il aur l ke saath karte ho, to aap usko double n hi karte ho, फिर लिखते हो. ओके, सो अगर जब आप कॉम्प्रॉन्द्र और उसके साथ भी करोगे, आप प्रॉन्द्र के साथ, तो वो ऐसे बनेगा.
ओके मैम, वही डाउट है कि डबल एन होगा.
हाँ, यू हैव टू रिमेम्बर इट्स गोइंग टू बी डबल एन. इल कॉम्प्रेन, इल अप्रेंड, रेस्ट इज गोइंग टू बी सेम. वो अकॉर्डिंग टू द रूल ही है दैट यू आर गोइंग टू रिमूव डीआरई एंड एड ओएनएस इजेड ईएनटी, बट डबल द एन एवरीवेयर विद ईएलएल और ईएलएल. Okay,
ma'am.
Okay. Arav and Gauri, you can write this down now. Haan, Jagrit.
I cannot understand the fifth question.
Just a second. Okay, so there are still few irregular verbs left. I'm going to do two more today. That is dir and lir. Dir basically means to tell someone something, and lir means to read. So we don't have any exact way to conjugate them. This is something which you will have to learn. There is not any. It's just that the conjugation of dir and lir matches with each other. So it might be a little easy for you to understand both of them together. We write D-I-S. D-I-S, then we write L-L-D, D-I-T, With no, we write dison, D-I-S-O-N-S. With wo, write D-I-T-E-S. It's completely exceptional. Then with ill, we write these, D-I-S-E-N-T. So this is our conjugation with dir. Now when I conjugate the verb lir, you will see that I'm going to write everything same. Je li, L-I-S. Tu li, L-I-S. Il, L-I, L-I-T. With nu, L-I-S-O-N-S. With wo, it's different. It's lise, L-I-S-E-Z. Whereas here, it is D-I-T-E-S. And with ill, it is going to be L-I-S-E-N-T. So the conjugation of lir and dir are kind of similar with each other. What you basically have to remember that with dir, that wo dir is completely different. Rest, the conjugation of dir and lir matches. Now, what is the actual difference here? That we don't write D-I-R-O-N-S or L-I-R-O-N-S. We write D-I-S-O-N-S, L-I-S-O-N-S. That is why this conjugation is, these two come in the irregular category. So these are the last two verbs for today. We are going to continue with the same topic in the next class as well, because we still have few RE ending verbs to do. Okay. So right now you can copy this down.
Yeah, ma'am. Mama,